Welcome to an example on how to graph a parabola with the vertex at the origin, as well as find all of the key characteristics of the parabola. Let's start with a quick review. If we have the equation of a parabola that fits this form here, notice how the x term is squared and the y term is to the first power. The parabola will have its vertex at the origin, and the parabola will open up or down based upon the sine of a. If a is less than 0 or negative, the parabola opens down. If a is positive or greater than 0, the parabola opens up. If we take a look at our graph for a moment, again, if the parabola opens up or down and the vertex is at the origin, the y-axis will be the axis of symmetry, which has the equation x equals 0. The parabola is symmetrical across this line. We can think of it as cutting the parabola in half. Or if we fold the parabola across this line, it would match up perfectly with the other half. Next, the distance from the vertex to the directrix is equal to the absolute value of a, and so is the distance from the vertex to the focus. So determining the value of a from the equation and then the absolute value of a will help us find the equation of the directrix as well as the coordinates of the focus without having to memorize these notes here on the side. And then finally, this green segment here is called the focal diameter or latus rectum. It has a length equal to the absolute value of 4a. It's parallel to the directrix, passes through the focus, and has both endpoints on the parabola. So if we find the latus rectum, it'll help us make a more accurate graph of our parabola. So going back to our example, notice how our equation does fit this form. But let's go ahead and change the order of this so it matches perfectly. We can write the given equation as x squared equals negative 3y. Again, because it fits this form, we know we have a parabola that has a vertex at the origin. So the vertex has coordinates 0, 0. And then the sine of a will tell us whether the parabola opens up or down. So looking at the form of the equation, notice how 4a must equal negative 3. So 4a equals negative 3, divide both sides by 4. We can see that a is equal to negative 3/4. Or if we want the decimal value, a is equal to negative 0.75. So because a is negative, we know our parabola opens down. So to help us find the focus, directrix, and so on, let's go ahead and make a rough sketch of a parabola with the vertex at the origin, which would be this point here, and that opens down. We'll make a more accurate sketch a little bit later. The reason this is helpful is we know that the focus will be inside the parabola, or that the parabola wraps around the focus, which tells us the focus will be below the vertex, and the directrix will be a horizontal line above the vertex. And the distance from the vertex to the focus is equal to the absolute value of a units, as well as the distance from the vertex to the directrix. Well, the absolute value of a would be positive 0.75 or positive 3/4. So the focus will be 3/4 or 0.75 units below the vertex, roughly here. And the directrix will pass through a point 3/4 of a unit or 0.75 units above the vertex, somewhere through here. So the directrix would look like this. And now by looking at the coordinate plane, we can find the coordinates of the focus as well as the equation of the directrix. Because the focus is 0.75 units below the vertex, it would have coordinates 0, comma, negative 0.75, or if we want, 0, comma, negative 3/4. Of course, the formula says add a to the y-coordinate of the vertex, which we can do, but I think if we understand the geometry, it's that much easier to remember. And then because the directrix is a horizontal line 0.75 units above the vertex, the equation would have to be y equals positive 0.75 or y equals 3/4. Again, the formula says subtract a from the y-coordinate of the vertex. Notice 0 minus negative 0.75 would give us the 0.75. But again, understanding the geometry makes it that much easier. And then we discussed the axis earlier. Because the parabola opens up or down and has the vertex at the origin, the axis will always be the y-axis, or this line here, which has the equation x equals 0. So for the last step, we'll find the length and the endpoints of the latus rectum, which will also help us make a more accurate graph. Since the latus rectum has a length equal to the absolute value of 4a, notice 4a is equal to negative 3. The absolute value of negative 3 is positive 3. So the latus rectum has a length of 3 units. Remember, it passes through the focus, and it's parallel to the directrix. So from the focus, if the latus rectum has a length of 3 units, one endpoint would be 1.5 units to the left of the focus, or here. And the other endpoint would be 1.5 units to the right of the focus, or this point here. So this segment here would be the latus rectum. So again, looking at the coordinate plane, we can determine the coordinates. Endpoint on the left would have an x-coordinate of negative 1.5 and a y-coordinate of negative 0.75. And the point on the right would have an x-coordinate of positive 1.5, comma, negative 0.75. And now we can make a more accurate graph of the parabola because we know it must pass through the endpoints of the latus rectum. It would look something like this. Okay, hope you found this explanation helpful.